From the sharply drawn structures of the gigantic underground fortress to the carefully crafted dialogue, Neon Genesis Evangelion is an incredible work of art. It premiered on October 4th in 1995, and ever since then, it has amassed a particularly devoted fan base. I'm not sure if you have ever considered what the title literally means, but if you take it word for word, then it says, "New beginning, good news." So really, it is a fictional piece with some actual ties to the real-world religious text of the Bible. I'm not here to discuss the philosophical concepts posited in the show, but I am here to evaluate the fact that the show is objectively beautiful. The actual content of the show's morality is something I will let you guys contemplate. On a more personal note, Evangelion is close to my heart because I watched this show when I was going through a difficult time in my life. I think everyone goes through a crucible that permanently shapes them. In Evangelion, Shinji Ikari, the main character of this anime, has to decide whether or not he will become an Ava pilot. An Ava is a gigantic half-robot, half-living creature that neurally interlinks with human beings in order to fight an angel in hand-to-hand combat. An angel is a creature of unknown origin that is basically a kaiju, so a big monster like Godzilla. Shinji eventually accepts his role as an Ava pilot, but he goes back and forth, quitting and then coming back and finally deciding to stay. He goes through this personal journey of learning about the cruelties of the world with only an imitation of a mother in Misato Katsuragi and a very distant father in Gendo Ikari, his biological father. Now, Misato is a woman in her late 20s who is Shinji's guardian and in charge of all missions involving the Evas. This show discusses many themes and topics, from what it means to become an adult, how to deal with loss, why it's important to fulfill your duty, etc. I think that those things are why I was so drawn to this show in the first place. It was a real and gritty depiction of reality, but it was sewn into a fantastical storyline of gigantic monster battles. While I was simply impressed with all of the underlying themes of this show, I was impressed by the incredible works of art that were shown off in this story. Just look at these detailed drawings. Don't you think that these drawings have much more weight to them than drawings from new anime? Each building looks heavy and fortified. There's no special sparkle, but there is dirt and grime where there should be. It's almost tangible in nature. Nowadays, you see anime that are all clean and almost sparkly, but this show grasps you with realness. It doesn't hold back in dialogue either. I want you to listen to this conversation. It isn't a normal convo to have, but it's a meaningful one. In life, you get to discuss meaning once every so often on a summer night when it's late and you might be thinking about the future. But in this show, it is chock full of existentialism. Here you go.
Driven from paradise, man escaped to this earthly existence on the edge of death. Created by the weakest of beings, created by the sapience born from that weakness, this paradise is our creation.
To protect ourselves from the fear death instills.
As you can see, deep conversations like these had all the time in this show, which is a rarity for most shows. That's part of the reason why I love Evangelion, because of these meaningful discussions. Okay, we can finally get to the most well-known part of this anime, the music. The opening is one of the best introductions in anime of all time, sung by Yoko Takahashi and written by Nico Oikawa. Here's a little clip. The scores in the show are also incredible. Someone really took time and effort to compose this beautiful music that set the scene perfectly. And his name was Shiro Sagisu, which I totally just butchered, but he apparently won the award for best music score in 1997, given out by Kobe Animation, which that totally makes sense. The scores simply have a momentous feeling to them. It sounds cinematic in tone because of these loud drums that disrupt the atmosphere as if these giant monsters are in fact wreaking havoc on the city. For all intents and purposes, this show is legendary. It feels like one big epic saga of great magnitude. That's why it's considered a classic by so many anime fans. And to its credit, it helped a lot of people. I've seen YouTubers I respect look at it and be reminded that it helped them. For me, I know that it is a depressing show. Shinji truly has to accept his position in the world, and that's not an easy task. We all have our own role to fulfill. Some people people don't know what it is, and others are somewhat figuring it out. But for me, I identify with the fear and isolation that Shinji felt. But he realized that there were people in his corner. A person who is introverted like me, I can see why Shinji did these things. He pushed people away, and he ran away from his problems. That's one of the major themes in this show. It's actually his catchphrase. Don't run away. Don't run away. Don't run away. This anime deals with real issues, and maybe that's why it's so relatable and quite legendary. Maybe it's light because of the things that I mentioned, the dialogue, the music, the artwork, but I think that it's truly beloved because it is authentic to the human experience, which makes sense because the creator, Hideki Anno, was severely depressed when he began writing this story. He used it as a way to work through his emotions and his insecurities and search for meaning. In the end, I applauded his final episode because it was a satisfying conclusion to Shinji's character arc, but the fans didn't appreciate the emotional ending. Some of them didn't like it. They wanted something else, so he gave it to them by making the movie The End of Evangelion, a violent end to the series in which he allows ultimate destruction of his own creation. And I might delve into that topic in a future video, but today I just want to appreciate the original ending of Evangelion. Neon Genesis Evangelion is a masterpiece, and I'm glad that I found it at the right time in my life. You can get pretty deep into the details and overanalyze it, but that's all that I have for you right now. I just really love this series. Thanks for watching. See you guys soon.